What's up, wrestling fans? I'm Chris Cash alongside Vince Russo and Nick Runreyes for the very first edition of Russo Plays TEW. And guys, just want to get it out of the way real quickly. You can find all the information at russoplaystew.com. That's where you can find links to watch all the episodes, where you can find a link to purchase Total Extreme Wrestling 2013 or any of the versions of TEW. We're going to be playing TEW 2013. It's a game created by Adam Ryland. It's a wrestling simulator game. If you're not familiar with it, I know a lot of the people watching this are going to be familiar with it. However, for those of you that are not, it's a very in-depth game, and we came across it several months ago. Vince went on a very cool charitable event. It was a live stream with the New Legacy guys. Go Google them, TEW New Legacy. You'll find them on YouTube. And it was incredible. Vince went on there just kind of on a whim and had a great time. And we found out that there was this passionate underground community that played these games that I had never heard of, Vince has never heard of. And we started reaching out to the community, and we wanted to try to do something with it. So this is the first ever inaugural edition of Russo Plays TEW. And without further delay, though, Nick, or Vince, let's introduce you, of course. Vince is over here. Vince, what's going on?
What's going on, man? Let's go. Let's book. Yeah.
And, of course, I'm Chris Cash. And our amazing expert, our game expert, Vince and I did not have a clue what we were going to be doing. And so we needed to reach out and find somebody. And Nick Runreyes, you can go to youtube.com/letsplayTEW and follow Nick. He's been playing these games forever. He's our expert. He's not on video, but he's the one that's going to be actually managing the game for us. We're going to be telling him, Vince is going to be telling him what to do, what he wants to do, and he's our game expert. So, Nick, thanks for joining us, man, and thanks for helping us out with this project.
Oh, no, thank you for having me. It's quite an honor to be the one that gets to control the game for Vince here. And I hope I can keep up with all the creative ideas that he has here.
So our idea, Vince, what we wanted to do with this was basically just to kind of give an overview. Every Saturday, we're going to be releasing a new video of you playing this game. We're starting off with this one, of course. Now, the first Saturday of every month, it will be completely free. So anybody can come watch it on our YouTube, youtube.com/PyroAndBallyhoo, and you can watch once a month, first Saturday of every month, you can watch us play this game. However, we're going to have additional videos every single Saturday after that, and it's going to be exclusive to the brand, which is the VIP section of PyroAndBallyhoo.com. So we're giving away one a month for free, but we're actually doing them every single week. And if you just can't get enough and you want to get involved and you want to watch every single edition, then go to PyroAndBallyhoo.com/TEW. And of course, that's where you can find out all the information. You can purchase a membership to the brand, to the VIP section, and you can watch all the videos. Also, want to throw out a quick plug to ewbattleground.com. It's a forum where tons of players gather, and that's actually where we found a guy. His name is Idol there. Go check him out. Want to give him a big plug because he actually set up the modification to this game that is allowing us to have Vince Russo book WCW 2000. Now, we're not going to get into a lot of the details of mods and all the stuff for those of you that don't know, but we will be explaining that on RussoPlaysTEW.com. So tutorial videos, things like that, you'll understand how you can get the mod and all that type of stuff. In the meantime, just understand Vince is going to be booking January. Is that where we're starting, Vince? January 2000 WCW?
January 2000, like I never left. So
right.
You know, I started in October 1999, Ed and myself, you know, and I booked October, November, December, left sometime in January, the very beginning. So this is going to be as if I never left.
Okay. Very cool. Well, let's get started. And guys, again, all the information is at RussoPlaysTEW.com. Please go. If you like it and everything, see the tutorial videos, think you can do it, go buy the game. through our link and play with us. And let's go with it right now. So we're going to switch over to this screen. This is going to be the majority of the time where we're actually playing the game. Nick's going to be operating the game. And we're going to start it off just like literally from scratch. So let's take it away. Let's load up the game. And let's start setting it up. Now, Nick, as you're kind of going through these steps, explain exactly what you're doing as you go.
So we have gone into a new game. And right now, what it's asking for is a name, which is a pretty obvious thing. It's what the game will be saved as. And it's asking you what regions you want available. So do you want the entirety of the world available to you, or do you just need the United States available to you? I usually leave them all on. The only reason you would turn some of them off is if you are on, say, a lower-end computer and you need to make sure that the speed is where you want it to be. But I believe for these purposes, we can just leave them all on and move forward.
Okay.
And we're going to create the new game. And it does take a little bit of time because it's processing a lot of information. It's processing every worker, every company. And you could play up to 8 people at one time. So there are multiplayer games. It isn't on one computer. It has to be, or it isn't online. It has to be on one computer. So if you have a bunch of friends that you want to invite over or something, you could play like that. We're going to be doing one player.
And correct. I do want to say this about mods, though. Like I said, Idle of EWBattleground.com did an incredible job. He spent a lot of time developing the modification because due to copyright issues and things like that, because you can't use names for these purposes and things like that, you have to, members or players will develop mods for different scenarios and different companies that they want to do. So a lot of people will do updated versions of WWE. You can play with all the updated rosters. You can play, like, this is WCW 2000, January 2000. So they actually have to go build out these mods if they're not already available. Nick, I do know there's a database that has a ton of mods available. So once you understand how to do it, there's a website you can go to, right? A very popular one in this niche community where you can download a ton of already made modifications, right?
That's correct. And the way that I've done it most of the time, and it's not only can you download them, but you could also see the feedback that's going on those modifications. The place that I go is actually graydogsoftware.com/forms, and then those modifications will be in the mod section.
Okay.
And what I could do is I could actually put together a little video that shows you exactly how to do that.
Yep.
How to download and how to install a mod. So be on the lookout for that. That'll be coming soon.
Very cool.
And the range of mods that this game can have is actually quite crazy. You have your fictional universes, you have your real universes, and I've even seen mods where they use comic book characters as the wrestlers. So. Yep.
So a ton of flexibility with these games from what I have gathered over the course of this. And like I said, we have a mod specifically built for our purpose where Vince Russo will play this game and book WCW, the roster's there. And the cool thing about it is it's not just Vince booking the creative side of it. We could have done that, but we're actually going to do all the management. There's negotiations with people that Vince will have to do. He's basically going to act as if he runs the entire company, and there's two different, you know, that's one way you can play, and then you can play as just the booker. But again, we won't get into a lot of the details and try to confuse you. We're just going to kind of go through a lot of the people that have already played this game or just wanted to see Vince and how he's going to do it. So we've already got it kind of into the game now, and now you're setting up Vince actually as the owner, right?
Correct. And one of the things you get to do when you pick who you're going to be, and you could pick any character in the game. So if you want to be Vince Russo, if you want to be any other person that you can think of in wrestling, you can do just that. This is your user talents. It basically makes you a personality in the game rather than just a static person playing.
Right.
So if you want to be better at signing contracts but not quite as good as leading the people in the back, you could distribute your points how you want here. For simplicity, because this is kind of the first time both Vince and Chris have played this game, I'm going to do it at default where everything is set kind of neutral.
Okay.
So it's going to be how the game is meant to be played, more out of the box. But as you get more familiar with the game, as you play it more, you're going to want to try and move these things around to see what they do, to see if it helps with your booking style.
Yeah. Just keep in mind, for the newbies that are like me and Vince that have never played this, it is very in-depth. Experts understand that, but it does take a lot to kind of – there's a big learning curve. But once you get into it, hopefully we'll help with some of it, because we have that dynamic. Nick's played it a lot. Vince and I have not. So we'll try to kind of keep that in the back of our minds as we present this to each of you, understanding the wide range of people that are going to be watching this. But all right, so where do we start? Where do we, now that we kind of get into the game?
Well, we're going to be selecting our company as WCW, as you stated, and I picked the owner. So we're going to go right into it.
There we go.
And this is the internet screen. It tells you everything that's going on in the world. As we just started, there's really nothing going on right now.
Right.
But if you go to the second screen, which is called your office,
okay,
this is where the game really takes place. This is where everything happens in your company.
So the messages from personal assistants basically is the things that you need to address as you get into the game.
Correct. And there are quite a bit here starting up.
All right. And so, do you need, before you get into booking, I mean, a lot of people just wanting to see him book a Nitro and how he's going to do it. Do we need to handle those beforehand?
The only one that I would say you have to handle is the storyline, since that's going to affect the grade. You'll probably want, after booking the first Nitro, to handle all the contract situations.
Okay.
But apart from that, the storylines is the most important thing. The way the game handles storylines is when you book either a match or an angle, it's going to check and see if that affects a storyline.
Okay.
So if there is no storyline set up, none of the storylines are going to move forward.
So right now, we really, which I think is what the kind of meat and potatoes people are looking for, so we can kind of start getting into setting up storylines, right?
That would be the first thing that you should do, especially, the only reason you wouldn't do it is if your company doesn't need it. But that's right. The first thing you should do in every game you start is set up the storylines.
All right, Vince, we're going to turn it over to you. I know you've had some time to think about all of this and kind of know which direction you want to go in. So, Vince, let's start looking at the storyline ideas and what we need to do.
Well, we're going to go into this. We're going to go into this with one major storyline because, you know, again, there's going to be a little backstory here. Let me give you a little backstory before we start this, you know, so everybody will understand where we are. You know, as you know, I was booking WCW 3 months with Ed Ferrara. During the week, it was probably beginning of the week or after. I don't remember what day it was. It was so long ago. But after we shot, Nitro and Thunder and did what we had to do, you know, I was called in the office. And, you know, I was called in the office under the guise of Hogan and Flair were going to be there, and I was supposed to have a meeting with them. I'll be honest with you. At that point, I hated being at WCW. I mean, mentally, in my mind, I was done with it. Earlier in the day, I literally had called my lawyer, and I basically said, whatever you have to do, get me out of this contract. I don't want to spend another day at this company. So this was what was going on that day, because you need to understand the background so you see where we pick it up. So, you know, I hated being there, didn't want to be there anymore, was asking my lawyer to get me out of my contract. I'm supposed to go to WCW to meet with some kind of a meeting with Hogan and Flair that were off the roster at the time. The reason they were off the roster is prior to me and Ed coming in WCW, they were just totally mishandling Hogan and Flair, just as two other guys on the roster. That's all they were. So I knew one of the first things we had to do was take them off TV, get them off the roster, and bring them back the right way. So they weren't on the roster at the time. You know, I was going to bring them back sometime after the new year. So I went into the office. I go into the office. There's no Hogan. There's no Flair. There's a very pale Bill Bush sitting behind his desk. And, you know, Bill basically told me, we've decided to go in another direction. At that point, keep in mind, having just spoke to my lawyer about getting me out of this contract, this was absolute music to my ears, because basically what they were doing at that point is they were in violation of my contract. You know, I got signed on, you know, as head of creative director, whatever the case may be. I had a 2-year contract with WCW. So you can't call me into your office and say, we've decided to go in another direction, because I'm the head of creative. So if you decide to go into another direction, go in whatever direction you want, but I'll take my money, please. So basically, that's what I said to Bill Bush. I let him talk about the new direction they wanted to go in. It was all political. It had nothing to do with ratings, and I knew that. But being that I wanted to get out of WCW anyway, I sat there very calmly, and I said, okay, Bill, I said, that's fine. I understand. I said, but I have a contract. I'm not interested in your new direction. I signed the contract as head of creative. I'm not going to be part of a committee. So you need to call Brad Siegel and just figure out how you're going to pay me. And I think that completely caught Bill Bush off guard, because I don't think he had any idea of how badly I wanted out of the company. So basically, that's what happened. That, you know, I went home, and they continued to pay me for the next 3 months, till eventually they call me back in, I think it was April. So that's where we are in the story. So now we're going to pick up this show. Like, you know how the internet is. Everything gets out on the internet. So now, leading into Monday's show, we're going to get into the conversations about Vince Russo may no longer be the head writer, or the the director of creative, whatever. Guys, I never cared about freaking titles. They meant nothing to me. But the rumor all week long, people talking about Russo may be out as head of creative. That's where we're going to pick up this story. Okay.
All right.
So what I'd like to do, Nick, and I'm probably going to throw a little curveball at you, because I don't think he's on the roster. We need to open up this show with Brad Siegel already standing in the ring. Now,
right,
Brad Siegel, for those of you who don't know, he was the head of TNA. He was the head of Nitro and Thunder at the time. He was the head of TBS and TNT. So Brad Siegel was right underneath Ted Turner. So that's why I had said to Bill Bush, you need to speak to Brad, and you need to see how Brad is going to handle my contract. So we need to start off this show with Brad Siegel in the ring, no music, no entrance. He's got the microphone. He's ready to speak. Can we do that? Nick, without screwing this game up?
I don't see a Brad Siegel. I can get you Ted Turner. Would that work for your purposes?
It'll have to.
At this point, yeah,
I don't think that would have been the scenario. Let me make that straight. I don't think I was Ted Turner worthy, but let's use Ted Turner for argument's sake.
Okay. So this storyline will be with Turner. Will you be involved in this storyline, I'm assuming?
Yes, I will.
And should I add any other people to this storyline at this time?
The entire WCW roster will be involved in this story.
All right, let's get some key ones here. You said that the meeting was supposed to be with a Hulk Hogan and a Ric Flair. Would you like them to be in the storyline to start?
Well, what do you mean by storyline?
With storylines, the way the game works, again, is if, say, you run an angle where Turner comes out and he runs down Vince Russo and he says blah, 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 or he praises Vince Russo and says blah, 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 that's going to advance the storyline in game terms. So anything where the two people or the four people or the eight people involved in the storyline happens is going to be. So if there's, for some reason, a match between Vince Russo and Ted Turner, then that advances the storyline as well. So anything where the two people in the storyline, any of the protagonists, as it says here, then that's what's going to advance the storyline.
I'll be honest with you, Nick. I don't know how you do this, and I've never played this game before, but the storyline is Vince Russo. He was just about to get screwed. Politics were just about to take his job. He basically played the contract card, and WCW realized, you know, either this guy's in power or he's going to sue us. So they made the decision to keep him in power because literally he had signed a contract 3 months ago. So the storyline basically is, Vince Russo, contractually in complete control of WCW. That's really the storyline.
Okay, so I think I get where you're coming from now. I've started that up. Now we can add, what we want is to have major workers. So if you, I don't want to like step on your toes, so I'm not trying to suggest anything, but let's say you have any wrestler on the roster become like your bodyguard. That person would then be involved in the storyline because he's going to be in a lot of segments with you.
Well, but see, that's the thing though, Nick. Let me ask you how this works, bro. Because sure thing. Nick, I don't want to give anything away. So can I tell the story and then can we come back and add those people? Because if I tell you all that now, I'm not letting the story unfold.
One thing we can definitely do is we can show them how the storylines are set up and then set it up off camera so that there's still the surprises for the viewers and then the game can still work the way it does. But unfortunately, you can't add people after the fact. What you can do, and it's a little workaround, and I could show you as we're booking, is you can book the angle and then add the worker to the storyline before you run the show. And that's not going to make sense right now, and I understand that. But hopefully, as we're booking, I can show you that.
We have the storyline set up right now with, of course, Ted acting as Brad Siegel, but... Vince Russo there. So, I mean, we've got those two key people in place, and we can go ahead and start booking out some of these other angles. And then, of course, as we get through it, if we need to, before the show actually airs or we book the actual Nitro, we can go back and add people if they need to be added.
Right. Yeah, that's correct. You can have up to, I believe it's 8 people in this version of the game.
Okay.
In a storyline at a time. And you could drop people out and add people as you want to. So
Vince, I guess the question would be, can you add, you've got two already with you and Ted in there now, because we have to kind of go along with how the game plays and operates as well. And generally, you don't have more than 8 people in a particular storyline. But can you just add a few of the key pieces to it now?
Well, yeah.
We can move on?
Nick, explain to me how we do this. Like, okay, Ted Turner says there were a lot of rumor rumbling around this week. I'm here to make things, perfectly clear that Vince Russo was hired in October as the director of creative for WCW. He signed a 2-year contract. And, for the next 2 years, I'm here to say that he will indeed fulfill those duties as director of creative. Now, do you put that anywhere in, like, because that would be seg one. So, like, how do you put that promo?
Well, I think the one thing I've picked up, and Nick, you can tell me if I'm wrong, is is if we look at it from a standpoint right now, you're setting up kind of umbrella storylines, and then you're going to be booking a show. So when you get into the segments where, of course, Ted comes out and does all that type of stuff, that's a segment that kind of plays off of the storylines that you create originally, which is what we're trying to set up now. So we kind of need to set up umbrella storylines, and then we're going to obviously get into booking Nitro. Is that correct, Nick?
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. It's more of a... loosely, this is what I want to have happen. I want to have a storyline with... Like, if I play a modern game, and I have a storyline with Ziggler and Daniel Bryan. So I'm not saying what's going to happen. I'm just saying I want a storyline that involves these two people to start happening. And then as I'm booking, that's where the points of the storyline will start happening.
So, Vince, who might get involved in the story with you and Ted or Brad and kind of this power struggle there? Who might be some of the key workers involved that we can go ahead and add to the storyline? And then you'll book it out at a later date, basically. But essentially, you two are the only members involved in the storyline right now. So are there going to be some others that you think will end up getting involved as this storyline unfolds?
I mean, Chris, like
unfolds?
I said, you know, the entire roster is going to be involved.
Well, let's just start off. We can add and go, but let's start with just a few that you know you're going to be putting in pretty quick. Because we can't, you know... I mean,
yeah,
just to kind of go along with the game.
I'm going to basically be telling them what I'm going to be booking on this show before I book it.
If you don't want to spoil it, what you can do, I'll show you a little bit in a couple seconds. But what you could do is book it first and then add the people later.
Okay.
So right now, this storyline is good.
Listen, here's the deal, guys. Nick, I have no idea how to play this game, Nick.
No, that's cool.
It's important. It's very important for me to try to show people the proper way to book a show. Shows sure. aren't booked properly today. That's why ratings suck. I want to show them the proper way to book a show, and part of how you do that is the flow of the show. You know, I mean, seg one goes into seg two, goes into seg three. That's how a show is written. And I don't want to do anything here that I would do differently as opposed to if I was really sitting down and writing Nitro, because that's not the way I would write a show. That's not the way a show should be booked. And I don't want people to think, quite frankly, I did it that way. So, you know, my idea was, you know, I'd rather, you know, I start with seg one, and then I will walk us through the entire show. You know, one segment will play into the next, and you will have a continuing, you know, two-hour show storyline that will lead us right into next week. Is that possible?
Yeah, I could do that. Absolutely.
We still need to finish setting up some storylines, though, right?
I could actually, and I'm going to show a way that you can do it the way Vince is, because some people do book that way, and I think a lot of the issue is I book, when I'm doing it on my channel, I think I book the opposite way of Vince, where I set up storylines, then I book to the storylines, and it sounds like Vince is wanting to book and then make the storylines, make it based off the booking. So
and we probably should have done this before we get started or further. Let me first start. People are going to probably ask about this, especially those that don't know the game. How do champions? Just that's a particular thing that we need to look at. What's our champions right now? Let's look at our titles. Let's see where it is right as we speak, because that's another thing that Vince has to consider as we go forward. I don't know if you can just vacate every title and completely start from scratch, but we need to look at. I'm assuming the guy that developed Idol, that developed this. Put who was the champion at January of 2000? Is that the idea generally?
If you go to titles here, right under your roster in your home screen, you could pop up a screen that'll show you.
Okay.
Now, the World Heavyweight's obviously the biggest one.
Yeah.
So we have Bret Hart as the World Heavyweight Champion.
Okay.
And he's currently a heel.
Right.
Going through, we have United States Champion Jeff Jarrett. Tag Team Champions are actually vacant at the current moment.
Okay.
Television title is also vacant.
Okay.
Hardcore title held by Norman Smiley.
Okay.
And Cruiserweight held by Medusa.
Cruiserweight held by Medusa. Now, Vince, just right off the bat, can you work with that?
No, they got to all be vacant.
I could do that.
Okay. So we're going to vacate every title.
Okay.
And start from scratch, Vince, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Is that something that you're going to do on the show where you have someone come out and vacate them? Or do you want to just
I'm going to do it right here.
All right. So if we just vacate, it asks if you're sure so that it avoids you accidentally clicking it and having it done. But there we go. And I'm going to go through and just do this quick.
Yep.
You go. We have clean slate now to start with.
And we can also get rid of, I think, Vince, you were going to end up getting rid of a title and just not using it, right?
Yeah.
We had talked about, what particular title or titles do you want to
I would get rid of that. I would keep the main, the U.S., the hardcore, and the cruiser. I would get rid of the TV title.
Okay.
Okay.
Because so you can completely get rid of the title, right? Retire it?
You do that by retiring it. It doesn't completely get rid of it. Yeah. So if, for example, in 4 years of booking or something, you want to bring back the TV title in 2004, you can.
Okay.
So they're never really gone forever.
Yeah.
They're going to be off of this screen.
Okay. So we'll get rid of basically the TV title, and it is no longer in play. So all titles are vacated, starting with literally a clean slate as far as that goes. Now we can kind of get back into the idea of him booking shows, and then and that'll play into the storylines that we're going to end up having to set up kind of after the fact, kind of the backwards way that you do it. Right, Nick?
I wouldn't say backwards, because I think that it's just a different way than I do it, definitely.
All right.
I do want to let Vince know one thing, and that's just something that the game, the way the game works, you do need, for the size of your company, which is a national size company, at least 3 storylines.
Okay.
So I understand that you have that one over-encompassing storyline, but there will need to at least be 2 more, or the fans are going to get antsy for more things to latch on to.
All right, so Vince, I mean, outside of kind of the umbrella storyline that you're talking about, what other kind of storylines, I mean, have you considered, or do you want to look at doing?
You know, Chris, it's just difficult for me because I'm giving stuff away.
Well, it'll be okay to give some of it away. I mean, we have to play within the confines of the game, too, you know, so.
But what happens if we don't tell them the storylines up front? They're still going to get storylines, so what happens?
I can actually set it up and show how to book that. Because, again, I'm sure there are people who book where they want to do the show and then set up their storylines based on the ideas and the stream of consciousness that they have from booking the show. So, without further ado, we do have these contracts that we want to take care of, but they can go a day. You do have, because it says they entered the final month, you have 28 days to deal with this.
Okay.
So you're fine. And that's another weird thing about Total Extreme Wrestling that takes a little bit to get used to. Every month has 28 days. It's just a limitation of programming.
Interesting.
So
we'll need it probably by the second show. I mean, we can go ahead and start getting into some of that stuff. I mean, obviously, with the time that we've put into this so far, we definitely want to get into, you know, booking a Nitro, essentially, and kind of going straight there. Now, this is showing. Now, what is this screen here showing us?
This is the main screen for booking a show.
Okay.
So this is giving us all the information we have at a glance. First thing, we have a backstage rating of 76%, which actually isn't too bad.
Okay.
So your backstage, it's not perfect. Everyone isn't holding hands and singing Kumbaya, but you're not going to really lose points because people are unmotivated, which is a thing that if you have a bad enough backstage, if you have enough negative influences backstage, you're going to have unmotivated people who aren't going to work as hard, and your grades are going to suffer.
Got you.
Another thing it's telling us quickly is our absent workers. So Goldberg and Wraith are both injured currently.
So they're available for angles, not available for matches.
Correct.
Oh, well, and Wrath is unavailable for angles, but Goldberg can actually be used in angles, just cannot work a match.
Yes, and depending on the severity of the injury, I think, I don't remember what Wraith or Wrath had at the time, but I know Goldberg had a broken arm, if I'm remembering correctly. So he could come out with his arm in a sling and cut a promo, but he can't jackhammer someone with that arm.
Now, notable other factors down below, the backstage rules are having a negative effect overall. What does that mean?
That's pretty deep down the rabbit hole. You are allowed to set backstage rules such as like no alcohol backstage, no smoking backstage.
You.
We could definitely get to that, but I think
yeah.
The big thing is this glaring red button that says locker room incidents.
Yep.
This means that something happened that requires your attention. And this is where Vince is going to have to make a decision. There is an incident involving Emery. Is that Hale? It is.
Hale.
Emery Hale. And the incident is, you don't need to do anything. He gave the locker room a lift by doing some impressions of some of his colleagues. So your backstage is going to go up when you get little things like that. If you notice, it went up from 76 to 77.
Interesting.
And in notable other factors, it now has Emery Hale doing impressions.
Okay.
So things like that, little random events that help.
And that's
your
part of, again, that I think with this game and what we're doing here, I mean, Vince Russo plays TEW. That's a big part of this. So even though a lot of it is just booking a Nitro, it's also playing this game. We want to get people interested in it and open it up to a number of people. And it's a very in-depth game. There's a lot as we go along. You'll see if you're not familiar with this game. But so we're pretty much ready to add angles and add matches and him book his first Nitro, right?
We are. And if I remember correctly, Vince, you said you wanted to start with Turner in the ring.
Yeah.
How do you want that angle to play out?
Turn is in the ring.
Okay.
Basically gives Russo a vote of confidence.
Okay.
That he will be the director of creative for WCW until his contract expires in, I guess it would be October 2001.
Okay. So the way I can do that, do you want to be on screen for this or off screen?
Not yet. No, not yet.
Okay. So let me make sure that you are off screen. And it is going to be based on Ted Turner's microphone skills and Vince Russo's overness. So that is what the grade of this angle is going to be. So it's really dependent on how good Ted is on the mic and how much people care about Vince Russo in 2000. Which, from what I saw, should be pretty decent. Now, how long do you want this angle to go? It has to go at least 3 minutes.
Oh, what do you mean the angle? The
segment.
The vote of confidence, the segment, sorry.
The whole segment?
Just this part, just the vote of confidence section.
Just the turn of vote of confidence?
Yes.
A minute. You said it's got to go at least 3?
The minimum is 3. Would that be acceptable? Do you want me to try and find another...
Yeah, that's way too long. He's, you know, turn is, you know, I mean, he would say this in less than a minute.
Okay, so let me, one of the great things about the game.
Can any promo go less than a minute, seriously?
And we want to have this based on, so if we got for 1 minute and it is two participants, or one participant because it's just Turner in the ring. Oh, we got to have the two. Okay. So hold on. So for 1 minute, it's looking like there can't be anything in the default angles. So here's one of the things that we can do, is we could actually change the angles in the default set. So if you don't like something, like we want to have this, you know, the authority announces, you know, he comes out and announces the authority, announces that Vince Russo's here, he's the power in charge,
right?
This, that, and the other thing. You click on clone angle, and Vince specifically said he wanted to be off screen, so you set the appearance here to off screen, and you want it to make sure it only runs for 1 minute, so you set the minimum time to 1 minute. And one thing that you could do is after you use it, you can have it removed from the database. So it could just be a one-time thing that you use.
Oh, okay.
So you're not cluttering up your computer with all these one-time use things.
Right.
So really very quick, cool. I'm going to save this.
So you cloned an angle that was already there and just to use for the purpose. And then you set it to get rid of after it's used.
Correct.
Okay.
And now it's, instead of being close to but not quite where we wanted it to be.
Yep.
We have it as what we want it, which is
right.
Ted Turner introduces Vince Russo as authority figure.
Okay. All right, so, Vince, what's next?
Hey, and Nick, I have to ask you this because I saw it up top. You mean to tell me that this game is designed, I mean, if I'm supposed to be booking Nitro, there's commercial breaks. I'm not writing between 115 to 125 minutes. I mean, can that be adjusted?
That cannot be adjusted, but one of the things you can do is, and I know this is something that's a touchy subject with you now, but the way it's booked now is you can have matches where, and it's supposed to simulate sort of modern wrestling, where the matches will continue even during the commercial breaks. Or you could even have a 2 to 3 minute angle where, you know, someone cuts a promo or someone does something that wouldn't be on TV. Or you could even have people like giving out t-shirts or something, something to fill the time where a commercial would be. But this is the idea that even though the camera's not running, the show doesn't stop type of booking. So unfortunately, the game is limited in that regard, where it doesn't take into account commercial breaks.
All right. Well, let's just see where we're at once we kind of get going with some of it.
And the booking's more so for as if it was a live audience. So that's sort of the way you have to think about it after a while, as if you're booking for the live audience and it's being also shown on TV.
All right. So where are we at with segment two, Vince?
Well, we're still in seg one, right?
Well, yeah, I guess technically. For your purposes, so we are.
What happens after the vote of confidence there?
Russo comes out.
All right. Are you going to sort of have a back and forth with Ted,
no,
or are you just going to come to the ring and...
He leaves, you come out, right?
Yeah. No, he can stay.
Okay.
I come out, he stays.
All right. Are you cutting a promo or...
Yes.
Okay. This I can do. So you come out and you are doing basically self-promotion. You're coming out and sort of advancing the storyline. Is there anyone you're talking about, or are you just sort of cutting a promo about the current situation?
I'm cutting a promo about the current situation, and then I'll segue into how it's going to be now.
Okay, so in terms of the game, the way it works is if you're talking about like what you just talked about, if you're talking about themes, if you're talking about anything else, you want to have it where it's just yourself talking. Or if the worker is just talking about either himself or the company or something like that. If you're talking specifically about someone, so if you came out and cut a promo on Sting, for example, you would want to use something where Sting is also in there so that you get... Because the crowd would pop based on Sting's name, so you want that also included in there. So right now we just have Vince Russo talking about the state of affairs and how things are going to be. About how long would you be talking for?
Well, what I would do first is I would cut a little promo on Ted Turner, and then I would call the entire locker room out.
Okay. So...
It would be like a 2-minute promo on Turner.
Okay.
By the time you got the entire locker room out there, it would be another 2 minutes.
Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do that as two separate angles. One where you're doing a promo on Turner. And the second where you are basically, because you can't include an entire locker room as a subject. So I'm just going to have it be just you talking. Is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I'm going to set these up. All right. And one of the things that you can do, so what I'm using here is basically self-promotion. Now, we know based on what Vince just said that he's not doing really a self-promotion promo. He's calling out the locker room. So you can just change the segment name to what you want it to say, as long as really it fits somewhat close to what you're trying to do. It's going to be graded relatively the same. So there's a little bit of creativity and theater of the mind here, where you're using things that are close, or you're fitting things to other things. So Vince Russo calls out locker room. Okay. So you called out the locker room. Locker room comes out.
Okay, then I will continue on with my promo.
All right. Are you cutting it on anyone in particular, or is it just kind of continuing on?
Continuing on.
About how much longer? How long is the promo with them out there for?
See, it really sucks now because I'm thinking of, you know, when I laid this out, I'm thinking of this show with commercial breaks. You know, now, I mean, bro, you're talking about a difference of 36 minutes when you take the commercials out of the show. So now I'm going to go longer than I would normally go, and I know that probably somehow, some way is going to affect the grade, correct?
The thing that will happen is if you go over a certain amount of time, it becomes a major angle instead of a minor one. So if you're, you know, if Vince Russo's out there talking for 2 minutes, people aren't going to remember it as much as Vince Russo out there talking for 8 minutes. So it changes how much that particular segment affects the overall grade.
I'd say 10 minutes.
All right. So you're out there and you're talking to the entire locker room out there for 10 minutes.
Yeah, laying down the law. Okay. That's all you need to know is that.
All right. So I will calls out locker room. And lays down the law.
Lays down the law. Nobody can be trusted.
Okay. All right. So now we've set up basically the theme now, where you know no one's
trusted.
Wait,
add to this. Can you go back and add to this to make it clear?
Yeah, no problem.
Pulls out the locker room.
Lays down the law.
Lays down the law. Nobody can be trusted. Friends will fight friends.
Oh, we hit our space limit. So let me see here.
For a segment name?
Yep.
Yeah.
But I have an idea.
Well, you can keep it lays down the lore if you only have so many characters.
All right. I think the nobody can be trusted is an important part to add in. Definitely. All right. But there is a character limit, just so you know.
Okay.
All right, so you did your promo. Now where we go?
Now we're going to go. Can we go to an on-camera?
Okay. And then what's going on there?
The announces, Shivani, and, well, I guess Madden was there at the time. Who was the other one? Was it just the two of them?
I don't know who was on screen at the time, but we definitely had. Let me see who he has.
Go, just go, Shivani and Madden, recap what just took place.
Okay. So you have, for Nitro, you have Shivani, Hudson, and Heenan.
I want to get Shivani and Madden.
All right, you want Madden? Who do you want to replace?
Heenan and take out Hudson.
All right, so there's Madden. None. Save. All right, and that's how easy it is to change your announcers for a TV show, by the way. What I just did. So you want to have the announcers recapping.
Recap what took place, I mean, and give them 2 minutes.
Okay. Now give me 1 second because I just need to make sure that this is something that is in here. If not, I can make it real quick. All right. I will have to make it. Should be easy. Now this one, I'm assuming we're going to be doing a lot. So I'm going to keep it in the database. Announcers, run down last event. So you have announcer one, and he would be rated on microphone, and then Madden would be rated on entertainment, or would you say it's more microphone-based?
I'd say microphone-based.
Okay.
Should that be announcer two or?
Yes, I did. Thank you. And then so that was with you, so we're gonna go based on your overness there. And you are off screen. So one subject. And this is something where I'm not going to get into it now, but we may get into it a little later, where you can make sure that things auto write correctly and things show up in the commentary correctly. But right now, we just want to make sure that we could have a segment where the two announcers are talking about what just occurred. So we have just created that really quick, kind of quick and dirty there. But so we have Tony and Mark Madden and Vince Russo. And you said 2 minutes. And announcers run down Russo's speech, we'll say. Does that look good?
Yeah, two E's in speech.
Ah, my bad.
It's okay.
Get a free English lesson here. All right, and what do you want next?
I want to go to a live shot in the back.
All right, who do you want in it?
Let's say Ric Flair.
Yep.
Let's say Sting.
All right, and what, just so I know exactly which one to use, why don't you tell me what happens in this this shot, and I will pick the angle to tailor it. So what, Flair and Sting.
Flair is showing up to the building late after the speech went down, and Sting is smartening him up to what was said.
Okay, so this, so we need two people. So I'm filtering out only angles that have two people. Is it a heated confrontation or a friendly, like, hey, here's what happened type thing?
Well, it's a hear what's happened, but Flair gets upset. Not its Sting, but the situation.
All right. So hype backstage segment times two, both rated on entertainment. So that sounds exactly like what we just heard from Vince there. Flair arrives late. Sting catches him up. Flair is angry. How long did you want that to go for, approximately?
Two minutes.
All right. And we could always go back, because I know you were concerned about time frame. We could always go back and add or subtract time after you've already booked. So that's a luxury that you, I don't think you have in real booking, where after a segment's happened, you can't go back and make it longer. But in this, if you see later that you maybe want to have this segment go 4 minutes instead of two, you can do that.
Okay.
So, all right. So that happens. Flair is now angry. Are we cutting to the ring, or are we doing, how are we doing this?
We're going to commercial. Shoot. So I just got to roll with it, right?
Let's book it as if there were the commercials and we could fill in later. Does that sound okay?
I would go to commercial here.
Okay. So after commercial, what happens?
Let me just stop everybody there, because I want to explain something while I'm writing this, okay?
Okay, go for it.
First of all, I want to say this is going to be difficult. And like, Chris, you know better than anybody. What I'm worried about is I'm going to get hammered, bro, because they're going to poke holes all over the place because I can't be as thorough as I really want to be in the game. It's restricting me. But, I mean, it is what it is. But, you know, I know people are going to say, why didn't he say this? Why didn't he do this? Why didn't he do that? But I can only do so much.
Well,
but
for the game purposes, I think.
Clear. I'm sorry, Chris. Go ahead.
I'm just going to say, I mean, I think if you're explaining things as you go with what you're explaining, and then as it all ties in together, I think they'll be okay.
Okay.
Because if you're explaining it, I mean, for the game purposes, you know, you may just have one deal that has you out there for 10 minutes, but ultimately everybody's on screen. I mean, you're putting that stuff over.
And Chris, I'm going through a lot. I'm basically saying one thing I didn't say there, because again, we were restricted. What I'm pissed off, bro. So, you know, I'm calling Ted Turner out. Screw you. You're not giving me the vote of any confidence. I had you over a barrel because I had a contract. I'm here even though you don't want me here. So screw you. Now we're going to do things my way. This is what I would do again, but we only have so much, but I should have went back and added something in. Hey, Nick, can you go back and add something in?
Yeah, you want that in the Ted Turner promo, it sounded like. Is that correct?
No, go. After Seg 3, where it says Russo calls out locker room.
Yeah.
Okay, go after this one.
Yep.
Go to two things. We're going to do two things here if we have enough space, okay?
All right, lay it on me.
J.J. Dillon and Kevin Sullivan get fired on the spot.
All right, I'm gonna need to do a little fandangling, I think, but I can work with that because I know there's a lot of authority type angles. I don't know if there's fired particularly, but
I thought it said authority fired there.
Oh, did I miss it?
I don't know. Go back up. I saw the hired and then fired. I thought it was like at the very top of the authority ones.
Oh, here it is.
Oh yeah.
So do you want to do it at the same time, or because it only has okay? So I could just clone this.
Wait,
like we did
that's
earlier.
Announcers worker firing.
It's announces. So Vince is announcing that.
Oh, okay. I got you.
Yeah. So.
By the way, does it have Vince as a heel?
I could set that, but I do not know. Do you want them on? They would be on screen because they were in the.
Yeah, they would be out there with everybody else. The entire company gets called out.
Yep. Okay. That's what I thought. How long do you want it to go?
Let's make that a part of the overall promo. So listen, we're gonna do the overall promo is gonna be 8. This is going to be a minute, and then I'm going to give you another bullet point that's going to be another minute. So it's going to equal 10. So this will be a minute.
All right. So let me wrap up this bullet point here, and then we will move on. Nope. So one thing you do have to do is you have to rename it. So you just put a 2 at the end. Now I'm going to remove this from the database because we could always just clone again if we need to. And, I don't know how many firings Vince is going to do on screen, but I don't know how many 2-at-a-time firings he'll do. So it was, I know you wanted Sullivan and J.J. Dillon is not showing up, so give me 1 second to see why that is. And I will explain why he didn't show up, if that is the case. Although he might not be...
Oh, he's not in the game.
I'm not seeing him in the game, so I could just do Sullivan if that's okay with you, Vince.
We can't put him in the game?
I would have to do it and then come back. It would take a little bit of time. So, what I can do, let me just see here.
But I think for the purpose of the game, too, it'll be an issue. I mean, you know, you can just kind of, for the purpose of, you know, this stream, we can just say that he was out there with him. And just
yeah,
put,
and that's,
just
that's
put JJ, I mean, or just put... whoever, Sullivan.
Yeah.
Because I think you're gonna get the same out of the game as if you have 2 people, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So I don't know that we have to have him in there just to get your point across that you're firing them both.
Alright, so you're firing Sullivan and JJ.
Yeah.
Alright. The game wants it to be at least 2 minutes. Do you want me to clone it so it's 1?
That's fine, too. I can cut a 2-minute promo on them.
All right. Vince fires Sullivan and is it D-I-L-L-I-O-N?
J-J-J-J? No, just without the I.
Without the I. My bad. All right. And I will go back and change this, but what is our second bullet point here?
Okay, after the Sullivan and Dillon, right? The next one after that?
Yep.
No more friends?
Yep.
Are you going to write this?
Is there anyone going to be involved in this or is this just
not really, no.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, nobody's going to be no more friends.
Oh my goodness. No more friends.
Here to fight. How many space? How what do we got left?
We got a little bit more.
I would say refs, R-E-F-S, refs, only there for three count.
All right. Anything else?
That's it.
All right, so this has to be two as well.
That's fine.
So I'm going to reduce your original one down to six, so it'll be 10 total. So we have, let's see here. And let me just sort of read it out as I see it. Turner comes out and does a vote of confidence. You come out and tell him to take the vote of confidence and stick it. You call out the locker room, tell him no one can be trusted. Fire Sullivan and Dylan. No more friends, here to fight. And the refs are only there to count three. And then yep. The announcers break that down like I just did.
Yep.
And then we got the Flair and Sting segment.
Yep.
And I know Chris wanted to make sure you were a heel. Let's see. We have you as a heel. Is that what you want to be? Okay.
Lightweight.
All right. I want to explain something to everybody here. That's what I was getting on before we got to that. I want to explain the booking process to you so you understand it, because a lot of this doesn't take place today. And a lot of this is really fundamental. It doesn't matter if it's 99 or 2009 or 2016. A lot of this is fundamental television writing. If you see the last thing I did right there, okay, Flair shows up, he missed the meeting. All right, everybody's coming from the back now. He runs into Sting. Flair basically says to Sting, what happened? Sting basically tells him what happened. You know, Flair's a little bit pissed off. And at that point, I would have Flair going to look for Vince. Then you go to commercial break. You see the cliffhanger there. You know Flair's pissed off. He missed the promo. He's going to confront Vince. You write things like that at the end of every segment so you don't worry about people flipping away during the commercial break and not coming back. And again, I want to point out how important that is, because that's how every segment was written during the Attitude Era. This isn't a question of that was 1999 and this was 2015. This is television writing 101. You want to write every single sequence in a way where the viewer does not change the television channel. So that's why Sting tells them what happened. Flair's pissed off. He's upset. He leaves to go to Russo. That's where I would go to commercial break, and that's where I would come back to the top of Seg 2.
All right. So. Okay. Yep.
Okay. So are we ready?
Yeah. Let's go.
In the top of Seg 2, I would come back in Russo's office.
Okay.
And Ed Ferrara is with me.
Okay. Is just so I know for my purposes in the game. Is he essentially just there as a person in the office, or is he going to be contributing with...
No, he's
going
to get read the riot act.
Oh, okay. So I think I got you. Go ahead. Sorry.
Ferrara's in the office with Russo. Russo's reading him the riot act and basically telling him from this point going forward, he's nothing more than my stooge.
All right, so.
Now, I know you got Ferrara under Oklahoma.
Yeah, I can. Do you want me to make that change for you?
Probably, if you can. Okay.
So, we have authority here, where we have a bunch of different things that we can do with our authority figures. But I'm not seeing...
Well, we're also gonna have. I don't know how you do this, Nick, but as Ed exits with his tail between his legs, Flair walks in.
All right, so you're gonna have two different things here. What I'm going to do is basically having you cut a promo on Ed Ferrara. Did I say that right? I'm sorry. And how long do you want that to be? Just like a quick, like, You are...
Well, this is all going to be one scene, but you want me to break it down for you?
Go ahead.
Or you want me to give you a total amount for the whole scene?
Yeah, give me... What's the... Well, give me the whole scene and then the total amount, and I will break
total
it down
for
the game.
Total amount is I'm reading Farrar to Riot Act. Going forward, he's nothing more than my stooge.
Yep.
A flare bust in.
Mm-hmm.
Basically asking me to the effect, do you know who I am? Flair's basically saying I'm not taking his crap from anybody.
Okay.
And I'd basically tell Flair at that point, no problem, man. Go home and walk away from your contract. Everybody will be happy. And obviously he can't do that because of the money.
All right.
So how long is the total segment?
I'd say the total between the two, I'd give it 4 minutes.
Okay. So first thing I'm going to do is change. Let me see if they have it already here. Okay. Change him back to Ed Ferrara. And what I did there is I just clicked on Alter Ego. And Alter Egos are going to have what people are known as in their different places. So if you had Glenn Jacobs in WCW, you couldn't use the Kane alter ego because that's specific to WWF. You would have to think of a new gimmick for him or a new name. But we're just bringing him back to Ed Ferrara. And these are, I could explain all those pop-ups that happen, but right now, just for the sake of speediness, we're going to just have that happen. And I'm going to do two-minute segments there. The first one being you cutting a promo on Ed. And the second one being you and Flair arguing.
Give me and Flair 3 minutes then, bro.
Fine by me.
Yeah. Because, again, I'm just thinking now of that total time, you know what I'm saying, without commercials, so.
Okay. So, heated confrontation. There we go. All right, so we are now 22 minutes in. We just had a Russo and Flair heated confrontation where you told Flair to take his ball and go home, and Flair didn't. Where are we going next?
We're going to go back to the arena.
Yep.
And we're going to see a live shot of the ring decorated for a street fight or a hardcore match, whatever you want to call it. I'd say street fight.
All right, and just so you know, things like that are actually included in the match time. So entrances, like specialty setups.
What
so if you need to set up a cage.
What this match is going
to
be then, basically?
So if you're setting up for a street fight match, we're going to go straight to the match then.
This is going to be Hall versus Nash in an NWO street fight.
All right. So we're going, I'm just going to do street fight, but as you saw, the same as we did with angles, you can rename matches as well. So this is going to be a brawl-based match, so you want to make sure you have two people who are good at brawling. Although, Vince, your TNT representative has vetoed a street fight on air. Too risky.
Hmm.
So this is something that I can work around if it's something that you don't necessarily think would have happened. But if you can see this type of thing as a thing that would
have
happened back
in
the day, we can move forward. It's all up to you, man.
One naked match, but not a street fight? Go to hardcore, bro. Go to hardcore. That's fine.
Let's see what they say. Ooh. TNT's getting really...
They vetoed that too?
Yeah.
So they could veto... I mean, they'll veto... Probably
what happens
anything
if they veto it and I do it anyway?
I don't think you can. I think they just won't air. So, yeah, they're not allowing it. So they'll straight up not allow you to do that.
What about a death match?
I'm pretty sure.
It'll
probably
be the same.
I'm just going. I'm pretty sure they won't allow that. Yeah, they're being pretty strict on this one.
What about fans? They wouldn't know to bring weapons, though. You know what I mean? They wouldn't know that, though. You know what I mean? How would I book that?
Unless you just gave the front row.
What about First Blood? But... Same thing, bro.
Oh, I'm imagining anything that is a contact risk of average or above is going to get vetoed by TNT. So we're looking at.
Now, is that going to be through the whole show? Yeah, or?
See, I don't understand that. I mean, like, you know, not for anything, Nick, you probably don't know the answer to this, but, like, why would they have that when it wasn't, when we were, like, allowed to have matches like that on TNT?
That would be the mod, specifically. So that's something that we could change if you want to go back and change that.
Yeah, that just doesn't make any sense.
Well, I do think then we can work around it for the case of this show. Then we may have to just, you know, but for... Next week, are you able to change?
How about Brawl, bro?
Yeah, I can change it for next week. So we got Brawl.
Okay.
And you said Nash and Hall?
Yeah.
All right.
Can we go back to the original screen where you have 1 through 9?
I'm sorry?
Can you go back to the original screen where we have everything written out so far?
Do you want me to save this real quick, or do you want me to
save this? Because I want to add something before I forget.
Go for it.
Let me see where you could put this in. Bro, can you add another thing here?
Yeah, where do you want me to add it to?
After Seg 5, right? Russo... will be evaluating talent. See, I never stripped the titles either.
So okay, I can add both of those.
Huh?
I can add both of those.
Yeah, say Russo strips title.
Yep. So we've been using this one here. So Russo strips all titles. And then
we'll be evaluating talent. What's the next pay per view?
I believe we're booking to Sold Out.
And we'll be evaluating talent up to Sold Out.
And I could actually check that real quick. Okay. After I put this in. So this needed to go right here.
Yep.
So we go back to our Nash and Hall in an NWO street fight. How long did you want this to be?
8 minutes.
Okay. So here is your road agent notes. These are things like who wins, specific things that happen in the match. Now, you're not going to be able to do things like Nash, you know, does this specific move at this specific time.
I would just have Nash over.
Okay. And just so we do know, the things you can do is add specific finishes. So, like, a kayfabe injury, a DQ, things like that are going to
be... So, how did you go over, Vince?
Well, can we say how he goes over?
Go ahead. Let me know what you're thinking, and I'll see how I can put it in the game.
Say this, Nash goes over after both men exhaust themselves. I would have them exhaust themselves, and then I would have Kevin just drop an arm over him for the 1-2-3.
Okay.
I don't know how you would put that.
I'm gonna do it as an open match. because you said that they're both kind of exhausting each other, so there's not one person that really looks like they're better than the other.
Right.
And I'm going to do a all-out match, showing that it's physically intensive.
Yep.
Those are really the only ways that I can do that besides making it, because it's not a decisive victory. I could do a tainted win, but he didn't cheat or anything, so I wouldn't use that.
No.
The only other things you could add in is if you want it called in the ring or scripted in the back, or you could just leave it up to the road agent to decide.
Yeah, I leave that to the road agent.
That's generally what I do as well, just so you're aware. The only time you really want to script it in or call it in the ring is if you know you have two people who are absolute like legends at doing that exact thing.
Yeah.
So if you had like a Flair Steamboat in the 80s, you would want to let them call it. All right. And that's not for a title or anything, correct?
No.
All right. So you now have... Now, you said it was 8 minutes. It's going to bump it up to 10 for entrances and all that other stuff.
Okay.
All
right. That's okay.
So that's going to help you with your commercial thing that you were concerned about. So you're going to get 2 minutes on every match that you have on the show.
Yep.
So after Nash wins, is there... what segment are we going to next?
We're
going to
have one more live shot in the back.
All right. What do we got?
Ferrara.
All right. Sorry. You want to do that one more time? I don't know who that is, but
Ed Ferrara.
Okay.
Ed Ferrara. Oh, you saw the call. Ed Ferrara approaches Eddie Guerrero.
Okay.
And tells him he's up next in a match against Chris Benoit.
Hey, I could do that real easy. Here we have authority books a one-on-one match. So,
and Eddie's not happy.
Okay, is Eddie going to be... Would we rate Eddie based on entertainment or just overness there? Like, is he just on screen or is he actually, like, cutting a promo?
He's more or less just on screen there, I would say.
So it's really just his overness that's...
No. Let's have him cutting a promo. All
right, because,
I see that there's so many things I don't know how to understand. I mean, he would be putting the heat on Ed, and Ed would be giving him the old I'm just a messenger type of thing.
So essentially, if Eddie's... Like, if what you said is how it goes, that would be entertainment, because it's based on how entertaining Eddie can be putting the heat on Ed. Yep. But if Eddie just takes it, looks angry, and walks away, anyone can really do that. So that's based on how popular they are at that point.
Yep.
So I'm making a clone here because I want to make sure that Eddie Guerrero is on screen and that it's based on entertainment. But it's still, you're booking a one-on-one. How many minutes did you want that? Just like a quick one-minute
shot? Yeah, say 1 minute for that.
Okay. So we jump right into that, and Eddie, and who was Eddie facing? I'm sorry.
Chris Benoit.
Benoit, but he's not going to be in this pre-tape.
No, but he's being discussed, so we want...
Yeah.
You know. So Ed Ferrara books a singles match. I'm assuming it's implied that... you're booking it, so...
Yeah, he's the stooge. He's just delivering a message.
Informs Eddie of booked match. All right. And where are we going next?
I would go to commercial here, you know, and again, for people following me, now you know that Eddie's going to be facing Benoit before we go to commercial break, so you got a little bit of a hook there. I would come back, bro, with another live shot of me and David Flair.
All right. And what are you two doing?
Backstage? I'm basically telling David Flair, basically getting into his head. He's been in his father's shadow his whole life. Everybody's being reevaluated. It's a new day.
All right. Is Flair giving it back to you or talking back to you, or is he just kind of...
No, he's kind of listening. Like, you know, he knows what I'm saying is right.
All right, so that's more of a... Now, this isn't what you're doing, but this is the closest in the game. Almost as if you're a manager sort of trying to hype him up. So what we're going to do is we're going to select that one, but then we're going to change the segment name to match what you're actually saying. So Russo tries to get in David Flair's head. All right. And that's based on you and based on David Flair. Is that
all
right?
I want to add story to this, though, bro. I want to, like, when after, you know, I would be in Flair's locker room. When I left Flair's locker room,
yep.
I would run into Hall and Nash.
Okay, so you're going back to...
No, I'm right here.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry. I didn't know which Flair you meant.
Yeah, I leave Flair's locker room, and I run into Hall and Nash after their match.
All right, and are they... What's going on there?
They both cut a promo on me for being an a-hole.
Oh, my goodness. Dude, stop calling. Okay, sorry. So they both cut a promo on you. Are you giving it back, or are you just the subject here?
I'm getting the last word in.
All right. So this is a three-way backstage segment with all based on entertainment.
They confront me. I tell them if they don't like it, walk away from the money type of thing.
All right. You got an idea about how long that is? Just a
I'd say 3. Well, are you just that part, not the Flair part?
Just that part alone, just the outsiders.
I'd say 3.
Okay. Confront Russo. Insult. Fly. Russo tells them to walk. If they don't like it. All right. So we got... So Kevin Nash doesn't want a script on this. Are you okay with Kev going off script?
Yeah.
All right. Just as a me knowing the game type thing, it's going to be better if no one has a script than having one person off script and two people on.
That's good.
Okay. So... What that is in game terms is it's essentially a gamble. You're hoping that, and it's a gamble based on their skill on the microphone, but you're hoping that they don't flub lines or screw up or take it somewhere they're not supposed to.
Right.
All right, so we got that taken care of. Where do you want to go next?
I would go to the match. I would go to Guerrero and Eddie.
All right, just a one-on-one basic?
Yep.
How long are we going for that?
I would go with entrances. I would go 12 minutes, but I would have Eddie screw Benoit.
Okay. So that's a tainted win, and it's Eddie winning, correct?
Yep.
So there's two things that you have here. There's the tainted where his opponent cheats, like using an illegal weapon, or someone comes out to help, or foot's on the rope or something. And then there's the cheap win, which is like a count out or a DQ. Which way did you want to go on that?
Wait, say that again, bro.
There's two different ways that someone can basically get screwed out of winning a match. The first one is like a lighter version of it, where they're just using like a weapon that the ref didn't see, or they're, you know, someone runs in and the ref doesn't see it. It's sort of something where the person A won the match, but There's an excuse, the storyline continues. And then this one is more of the, he intentionally rolled out for the count out, or he intentionally got himself DQ'd type thing.
Well, see, I said up top, though, that the referee is only there to count the 1, 2, 3.
So it's a tainted, it's more like a tainted, he just ran out.
I guess so.
Yeah, so you gotta, that's right, see? So, did you want anything else with that match? Do you want it to be like a open, close bout, or do you want it to anything like that?
Competitive match.
Okay. And
you know, Eddie screws Benoit to win the match.
All right. So we have that there. We have Eddie going over. Is there any post-match fallout on that, or are we going somewhere else? Oh, goodness. I wish I could shut that off so I couldn't get inbound calls. Sorry about that. Go ahead.
So what's the post-match going to be?
I'm thinking. Nah, let Eddie just get out of there with the win. We'll address that later.
All right. Okay, so what's the next segment going to be?
Let's go to a scene in the back.
All right.
And it's going to be between Jeff Jarrett and Scott Steiner.
All right. And is it an argument? Is it they're cutting a promo together? How's it going?
Well, they're friends, but yep. Now they have to face each other. And however you want to put this, but Jarrett tries to work Scott into laying down for him, and he'll owe him one.
All right, how long do you want this to be?
And of course, Scott won't have it, and Scott's not going to do it.
All right, so that I could do that.
Easy. So, you know, Jeff just being typical Jeff, trying to work Scott, and Scott, you know, being smart enough to say, you know, no.
Jeff Jarrett tries to get his friend Steiner to lay down.
Steiner's EI, but I don't know if that really matters.
We want to make sure that my terrible spelling is corrected here as we go along. So, EI, Steiner. Okay, Steiner says no. You wanted that 2 minutes, or did you have a time frame on that?
Oh God, I could hear Steiner talk for 25 minutes. 3 minutes.
All right. All right. Where are we going next?
We're going to commercial.
That's good. You went to commercial at basically exactly the first hour break.
See that? So, and we almost are coming back with...
Yeah, go ahead.
What?
No, go ahead.
We're going to come back with a live shot now of Flair with David.
All right.
Basically saying, don't let that jackass work you.
All right, I got you.
Don't let anything come between a father and son type of thing, you know?
Is David talking back or no?
No, he gets the last word in, though.
All right, so.
It's Rick, all Flair, and then David would, like, get the last word in, so.
So Rick tells David, don't let anything come between father and son. And what's that last word going to be?
And David says, I hope it doesn't after I beat you.
I hope it doesn't after I... Oh, so we're out of room there. I can get this fixed, though. Hold on.
You could do father and then the backwoods slash their son. You know, you don't need the end. You know what I mean?
Start trying to save room here.
Yeah. And you don't even need to says. You could have David dash. I hope it doesn't after I beat you. I mean, people will know that, you know?
Oh, hold on. I got some double spaces here. All right. Okay. So, is that a couple minutes there, or how long you want that one?
Yeah, say two.
All right. Where are we going next?
We are going to... I wanted to... I made a mistake, bro.
What's up? What do you need?
Jared, the Matt after... no, that's the top. I'm okay. We're going to the match. We're going to Jared and Steiner.
All right. All right. And how long? How many minutes you want that match be?
Seven.
All right. How do you want it to end?
Steiner over with the Steiner recliner.
All right.
So I guess, Jeff taps.
Yeah, submission finish. That should make it so that it's with the Steiner recliner. Okay. So, and that's just kind of a clean, no DQ finish.
Yep, clean.
Is it decisive or?
Like, is no, I'd say it's competitive.
All right. All right, so we got that match done. Where do we want to go next?
We are, we're going to Bill Goldberg, broken arm and all, arriving at the building.
All right, let me mark him as a personality just so that we could have him in, because right now he's not assigned because he's injured. So I want to make sure that I can book him. And the way I'm going to do that is by setting him as a personality.
Well, the only thing is, bro, I don't know how you do this, but again, if I'm booking this show and he's got a broken arm and he's walking in with a broken arm, I'm making him work with the broken arm.
Game's not going to let you put a... Well, let's see if it'll... I'm just going to do a test here to see if it'll let him wrestle. But I think because it's a broken arm, he's just going to flat out refuse to...
Well, how do we know he's got a broken arm?
It's in the medical. I could show you that in 1 second. But yeah, you can't put him... Yeah, it won't let us put him in the ring. So he is medically unable to compete right now. So... If you go to your medical here, it shows Goldberg is currently out for 5 months with a fractured arm.
Well, and you know, I think the interesting part about that is, I mean, Vince, I don't know how it would work. I mean, you wouldn't have the ability, if he wasn't medically cleared, to book him in an actual match back then either, would you? I mean, even though you could probably protect him with a broken arm, but if he legitimately had a broken arm, I mean, y'all have to work around that. In real life, too, right?
I'll work around it, bro. Just have him show what's broken on there, bro. All
right, I can do just that. So it's just him arriving.
Yep, with his broken arm, he doesn't look happy.
Okay. So I saw it here. Worker arrives. That's a 1 to 3 minute angle. That's fine.
1 minute.
Yeah, okay. It's basically just like a shot of him walking in type thing. All right. So Goldberg arrived at the arena. So where are we going to go next?
We're going to commercial break after that.
All right. And then where are we going to go?
This is a live shot. Russo's office.
Mm-hmm. Who do we got in it?
Sting.
All right. And how is this going?
I'm telling Sting that he's wrestling Goldberg tonight.
Okay.
And Sting's telling me I'm out of my mind. He's got a broken arm. And I'll say, okay, bro, no problem. I'll get somebody else to do it. And you could sign up for unemployment tomorrow morning.
Okay.
And from there, we'll go to Flair and David.
Okay. So I'm just going to use this as the basis for that, where we have Sting in your office talking about Goldberg, essentially. And did you say how long you wanted that?
Say three.
Goldberg. Sting refuses. Vince says he will find another. Okay.
But I gotta threaten Sting there, bro.
Yep.
Can you get any more in?
Yeah, I'll put that in. Threatens to. Oh. He will. Vince threatens Sting will find another.
No, just say go. Vince threatens Sting by voiding his contract.
Okay. Okay. So we got 3 minutes there.
Okay, then let's go to the match. David and Rick.
David and Rick. How long do you want this?
God, look how much they look alike there in the face. Isn't that something?
Oh, man. I don't think I've ever noticed that before either.
Oh, with entrances and everything, I'd say 7 minutes. But I want to do something here, Nick. I don't know how you do it.
Hit me. Let me know.
There's no ref for this. But at the end, Ferrara goes down there with a referee shirt and quick counts Flair's shoulders. 1, 2, 3.
You ready for this? Screwy ref finish is actually
there. The you game. Go. But I want to make sure that you know they know it's Ed. You know.
I could do that. So it's okay. Who is getting the 1, 2, 3? Rick.
David's going over.
David's going over. So what I'm going to do here, and this is sort of a workaround, is I'm not. Replacement referee.
There you go.
Ed Ferrara. All right. So we have a screwy referee finish where Ed comes out and counts the 1, 2, 3 for David. That sounds like a tainted win if I've ever heard of one. And do we want to, because Rick is going to throw a fit backstage. Do we want to keep Ric Flair strong in this?
Yeah, he'd be dominating.
Okay.
You know what? And I just want to throw this in there just because I think it's going to be interesting. And as we go through this process week in and week out, you know, a big part of this is to let people know about this game. Another part is obviously to continue building our brand and having people that are playing this game and following Vince book this game and play this game. Sign up for our VIP section. We're going to have Nick in there as well, where he can answer questions in our forums for, you know, beginners and everything like that. Of course, I'll be in there. Vince will be in the forums as well. You can write your thoughts out in there and what you're playing, your games. But one thing I think will be really a lot of fun is for our VIP members, and Vince, I know you won't have any problem getting this hooked up, is we'll send this link to Ed Ferrara and let Ed watch Vince book WCW, especially putting him involved in it as much as he is. And I can't wait to see if Ed might, you know, just watch it and then give his reaction. Maybe he can do an exclusive reaction blog for our VIP members and, you know, give his thoughts on Vince's booking. And I think that'll be a lot of fun. So, guys, just as we go along, please make sure you understand that even though we're going to be releasing a free episode of this every single month, the idea is obviously for ongoing stuff with this, because it's probably going to be a pretty big thing as we go forward. We'll be giving a lot of extra perks for our VIP members. So pyroandballyhoo.com/VIP for more information on that, how you can sign up to become a part of the brand and get involved with this whole process as we go along. So should be a lot of fun. But that's one of the first things I think I want to try to do is get Ed's reaction to Vince's booking and stuff. And hopefully we'll have that soon for VIP members as well. But Vince, go ahead, man. We've got the match between David and Rick.
From that point, I would have, I don't know how you put this there, but I would have,
Ric Flair is furious at the booking of this match and has complained loudly that he wants.
That's exactly where we're going to go. First of all, I would have Flair knock Ed on his backside.
Okay.
Then I would have a Flair go to the announce table like a lunatic, throw on the headsets, and basically said, Russo, you better find a place to hide back there right now because this all ends tonight. So basically, Flair's pissed off. He's coming to look for me.
So, which it's funny because Nick in the game, he's obviously upset.
Yes.
But that's more of a behind the scenes. He's upset with the way it was booked, right?
Right. So this is something that is happening on screen, but behind the curtain, so to say, Ric Flair is in the game throwing a fit backstage as well. He doesn't want to lose, even to his kid, even in a screwy finish, even when he's protected.
I believe that. No, I'm only kidding.
So the game, unfortunately, the game doesn't take into account the kid part, which it should a little more than it does, but it doesn't as that sort of thing. But you can, just because someone's upset doesn't mean that they're going to stop working. They're going to do, you need to do a lot to get someone to basically walk out of the company. It can happen, but you need to do a lot. And I don't think Flair losing once to his kid is going to really, you know, move the company in a bad direction.
But those are things upset, that, again, as this stuff pops up in the game, we have to address it, you know? I mean, that's kind of the cool part about it, where I think a lot of people are wanting to see how Vince would handle things like that. So if push comes to shove and that type of stuff happens, we'll just have to deal with it as we go.
Yep. And, do you want to change the booking at all based on Flair saying that he doesn't, that's not, you know, he wants to go over, he doesn't want to lose, that sort of thing?
No.
Okay. And you, and again, you don't have to. There's definitely times that if anyone has creative control, like, say, Kevin Nash, that's going to be an issue that you have to work around. But Flair doesn't have the creative control where he's blocking it. He's just angry.
Yeah, and I want to piss him off anyway.
So all right with how long are we letting him throw a tantrum?
2 minutes.
All right. So he throws a tantrum after the match, and then where are we going?
We're going to break. I just want everybody here to see, do you see how everything going to break has a cliffhanger? And just for a lot of you guys following this, oh, bro, 90% of this stuff is off the top of my head. That's why I get so freaking upset when you watch Raw and when you watch Impact. Lucha doesn't do this, but when you watch Raw and you watch Impact, they go to a commercial break during a match, or they'll go to a commercial break at the end of the match. There's no cliffhanger. There's nothing bringing you back to the show. And that's the stuff that pisses me off, because there's no excuse for that. You shouldn't be a television writer if you don't know how to write cliffhangers leading to break. That doesn't just go for wrestling. That goes for comedy. That goes for drama. That goes for thriller. That goes for reality shows. Every time they go to the break, there's a freaking cliffhanger. Why that doesn't apply for wrestling anymore, I have no idea. But, you know, the ridiculous thing is that then they look at the rating and, okay, it's a 2.6. Well, maybe we should work a little harder on the ins and outs of commercial breaks. That's where I get pissed off about the effort. Nobody wants to work hard, because it's a no-brainer. You leave them with something that they got to come back to. Flair now is coming back looking for me. We pick it up on the other side of the commercial. He is on me in the back and beating the living crap out of me.
Okay. And is anyone, say, coming to save you, or is this just a...
No, everybody is there, and they're letting it go.
Okay. So what we're going to rate this is just on yourself and on Ric. And Ric is attacking you. Now, this has to go at least 3 minutes. So are you okay with that?
Oh, it's going to go longer than that.
How long?
This is going to be a whole scene, bro.
All right, so we're looking... The max it could be is 10 minutes. Is that okay?
Oh, yeah. It's not going to be that long.
All right. What do you got for me?
He's beating the crap out of me. The boys are letting him beat the crap out of me. I'm just trying to get away from this maniac. Finally, it's Luger who comes and pulls Rick off and brings him to, you know, just brings him to his senses.
Okay. So we have in this, and I'm going to do this as two separate angles. So it's going to be Flair beating you up and then Luger sort of talking down Flair.
Yeah, physically pulling him off and then talking him down.
So we have...
Well, wasn't there an option where you could have another person save him? I mean, that's pretty much what that is, isn't it?
It is, and I might do that as well. That actually sounds like a better idea. We have Luger as... What was he as? The total package. Do you want him as Luger? Because he's a heel right now. I think he was in... Was he in NWO at the time? I can't... Honestly, I can't remember, unfortunately.
I don't think so, bro, because that... No. He I'm almost positive he was a babyface at the time, but I could be wrong.
Okay. It has him as a heel, Lex, though, bro. But I could put him as Lex. Let's see.
Yeah.
There we go. All right. So we got Lex back. So
bro,
we got Lex back.
Dude? Who's that dude calling, man?
Yeah, I honestly don't even know who it is. I was talking to Chris about it before, and like, I can't even text him to be like, bro, stop calling me, because I don't even know who it is. It's someone who got my Skype somehow. Anyway. So let's see if we got a one-on-one with a save here. No. Okay. So we're going... What I'm going to do is I'm going to leave it...
Isn't this backstage, though, anyway?
I'm sorry? I didn't hear that.
I said, isn't this backstage? I mean, isn't there a section where it has, like, backstage segments?
Yeah, it has these sort of generic backstage.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah. But I think that might be best for the Luger and Flair segment anyway.
Bro, right. can you add one thing in there?
What's up?
I want Brett talking to me when I had him on me hot, right?
Flair or Brett?
I had Flair on me hot from commercial. No, that's okay. Leave it the way it is, bro. I'll figure it out.
Yeah, we have basically it's 3 minutes, so if you imagine just right now, and we could change it as we go, but he's basically beating you up for 3 minutes just to kind of give the audience like this is happening, and then Luger comes up and gets him off and talks to him. Is that how you want it to go, or did you want it?
Well, 3 minutes is too long, bro. Put 2 minutes for him beating me up.
Okay. And then how long for Luger and
the Luger
Flair?
Thing and Russo getting medical attention is 3 minutes.
Okay. So Luger physically pulls off Flair, talks him down. Down in background, Russo gets medical attention. So Luger doesn't want a script. Is that okay?
Yep.
All right, so I'm going to take Flair's script away as well.
Yep.
So you wanted this to be reduced by one. The minimum time it has for a one-on-one attack is 3 minutes.
So let's do 3 and 3 then.
Yeah. So we're going to have to leave it at 3. But you did express that if you were booking this, if this wasn't under the restraints of the game, you would have that only be a couple minutes.
Yeah.
So after Luger pulls Flair off, sort of talks him down, where are we going next?
We're going to an on-camera.
Okay.
And that's going to be interrupted by Goldberg's music and entrance.
All right, is he coming out to make like a promo, or what's going on with that?
Yeah, he's coming out with a mic.
All right, what's he What is he saying, basically?
He's telling me to come out to the ring so he could finish the job.
All right, so he's hot. Calls you out. Do you come out?
No, Sting does, because Sting's supposed to wrestle him.
All right, so let me see if I can... So what happens when... I'm going to have to do that in two parts, just so you are aware. Goldberg walking out, his entrance playing, the whole kit and caboodle, him coming out, and then him calling you out. How long would that be? Just that portion without Sting showing up.
A minute.
All right. Let me see what I could do then.
Well, actually, with the entrance and everything, it'd be longer than that, right?
No, not really. I mean, it's not a quick entrance, Chris, if he's PO'd and just coming into the ring, you know? Chris, you know what the funny thing is about this game? I'll be honest with you. I wonder if they talked to any bookers in developing this game.
I'm going to hazard a guess and say no.
Yeah, they should have, bro, because there's a lot of things that, like, you know, I mean, I think they would have, I think it would have helped the game if they actually realized, you know, how long this took or how long that took or, you know, that type of stuff, you know?
Like, well, this is more mod stuff than game stuff.
You know, you can't, in the back, if it's a one-way fight, you can't beat somebody for 3 straight minutes. First of all, they'd be dead. And second of all, they'd be so blown up, they wouldn't be able to go 3 minutes. So, I mean, it's just little things like that that I wish they would have, you know, if they would have talked to somebody, they could have really learned the ins and the outs.
Well, I don't know what the defaults are, but, I mean, that is the one part about it where they're, like he was saying, I mean, the modifications are obviously where you can kind of make those changes.
Yeah, this is not the default pack that comes with the game. So you're looking at stuff that, you know. So Goldberg challenges Russo. Russo doesn't answer, but here comes Sting.
Yep.
And what's going to happen? Are we just going to have, like, almost a mock match where Sting is going to beat down Goldberg? What's going on with that? Because I know you wanted to do an actual match here, didn't you?
Yeah. Let me just think of how this would play out.
Yeah, considering, I mean, we can't use Goldberg, right?
Right.
I mean, we can use him as a personality, but not as a... He can't take bumps.
No, they can have a fight here. He just can't have a match.
Right. So he can... You do want to be careful because angles have a what's called a risk to injury. So if you put an injured worker in something where has a risk to be more injured, he might get injured. He might, you know, make his injury worse and stuff.
That's okay. At this point, if I'm booking this show, I don't care.
All right. So we got...
Goldberg gets into a verbal confrontation with Sting.
Okay. And then... Why don't you lay it all out for me, and then I'll sort of break it down into how the game needs it done.
I'm just thinking how it would play out. He had a verbal thing with him. Goldberg would pie face Sting and go to walk away.
Okay.
Sting would take Goldberg from behind. Take him down from behind.
And then just...
The two of them would brawl, and then we'd have the agents come out and pull it apart to protect Goldberg and his broken arm.
All right. So I know in the default, there's something called the pull-apart brawl, and that's actually one of my favorite things to use, especially to end a show. So let me see if they have a brawl to the back. Let's see if they have something here that's pretty much the same. A lot of video packages. They have a brawl here, but that's including the call out. All right, I'm going to have to make it, which is fine by me, but let me just... Let me just get that done for you. So, I'm just going to clone this one here. pull apart brawl. And do you want to have like the people actually come out, actually be in? So like, do you want to use lower? Like, do you want like Kidman to come out and try and pull them apart? Do you just want like agents to come out and pull them apart?
Just agents. I know. Okay. Arn was an agent. I saw Arn on there.
Now, the thing is, with road agents, you can't have them on the screen because the idea is that they're working backstage. I could easily change them from road agents to personalities.
You have to.
Okay.
I would who do they have? I saw Terry on there. I would use Terry Taylor. I would use Arn. And one other guy, maybe.
I think I have that list handy, so let me see if I can pull it up. I know it was Arn, Terry Taylor. All right, I can actually get to it quicker. How many people you want coming out? Just like two or three to pull them apart, and then
yeah, just okay. Three.
All right, I'm gonna have just two right now, and they're not rated at all. These two are rated on that. This will work. All right. And how long does this brawl take place? It sounded like a 3 to 5 minute type thing.
I'd go four. Right.
Four is fine. Let me go and make sure Arn can do this segment. You said Arn and Terry Taylor?
Yeah. Good old Terry. Wished he still looked that young. Him and me both.
All right, let's get that angle in there. All right. So you got your Sting and Goldberg match, so to say.
Can you tell me how much time where we're at?
Yeah, let me get this on the show, and okay. Then I'll let you know. Sting or Goldberg, Big Leagues, Sting, attack. Did he attack him from behind? Am I remembering that right?
Yep.
Berg. From behind, agents pull to brawl apart. Okay. We're clicking buttons we're not supposed to. We are 25 minutes left to go. Let me modify that so it's not
25 minutes to 1:15?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, oof. All right. I'm going to have to stretch things a little bit here.
Like I said, we could always go back and, you know, you could add some time to matches or stuff like that.
Let's continue on. We want to go off of this hot.
Okay.
We want to come back with Goldberg being subdued in the back by Terry and Anderson, and he's ripping the backstage area apart.
All right. Is anything going to come of that, or is that just him, like throwing his fit, and then we're gonna cut to something else?
We're throwing his fit. We're gonna come back to it on camera.
All right. So I'm just gonna have him backstage, doing his thing for a couple minutes. Goldberg. Destroys. Backstage in anger, we'll say. That sound good?
Yeah.
All right. So what we got next?
How much time? 2 minutes? Can you give that one?
I cannot unless you want me to go back and clone it.
If you can't, that's all right.
Hey, these extra minutes are helping you get to your 120 there too.
All right, let's go to an on-camera recapping tonight.
Okay.
And we're waiting for the main event, which is next, but we don't know what that is.
Oh, okay. So, da 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 da.
We have our two, and that was Madden and
Go to Madden, and we're going to go to an on-camera of Madden and Tony. Can we do that for a minute?
Yeah, we should be able to. I just got to find it because the announcer stuff. I'm going to have to add some stuff after this to make sure that we have it, because I know these are things that you do like to use here, where you have the announcers doing recaps, and it's not in this angle pack. So I'm going to need to add that.
I thought you did add that and made it stay in the database.
I did it for them recapping, Vince, but that would have to include a worker again.
Oh, right.
And I'm going to add a whole bunch. I'm going to add it so it can include 1, 2, 3, 4, that sort of thing. So we have this whole set of people. But let's see. We're going to add another one, where it's microphone and microphone, and it's just the two of them. Two announcers run down events of the night. Nope. And that's just basic. Like,
do that for a minute, but then I want them to go to like a 2-minute package where we're going to see what happened over the course of the night.
All right, who is going to be, like, predominantly shown in that package?
I guess me. Everything that I did, I guess.
All right.
But it's basically, like, you know, a little of everything we saw, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm picking it up. I'm trying to think of how that would run down events of Nitro. That one's actually easier to do because that's already here. So we got, let's say we have it be, because the main focus of the night was you. There was a bit with Flair, the two Flairs, so we can include them. Would there be anything else you focus on in those 2 minutes, or would it really be focused on, like, just focused on you and all of the changes?
Obviously Goldberg and the Sting bit and stuff.
Goldberg, Sting, Nash, and Hall.
All right, we got room for one more, and that's it. If just you want, more. Or we could keep it at those seven.
Do Nash and Hall, because we did Goldberg. We just saw Goldberg, Sting.
Okay, so the way I have it right now, it's Vince Russo, Ric Flair, David Flair, Kevin Nash, Scott Hall. And I guess your choice is, do you want to have it be the Goldberg Sting bit or the Guerrero Benoit bit that's recapped?
Oh, the last one?
Yeah.
Let it be I'll let it be Steiner Jarrett.
Oh yeah, that happened as well. So Steiner and Jarrett. And you want that all done in 2 minutes?
Yeah.
All right.
So now we're main event time, right?
Yeah, we got 20 minutes left to go. So if we're not on the main event, we got to be getting close there.
No, we are. We got 20 minutes?
Yep.
Let's go back in it. Can we go back and pad some of this?
You want to do that now? Sure.
Yeah, go to David and Rick. Go to
match?
Go to add a minute to that.
Well, how are you closing it, though? You not have another match in there?
Yeah, I am. We got plenty of time, though. There's no 20-minute matches on Vince Russo shows, bro.
No, not 20-minute matches, but I assumed you'd probably end up having a match, and then you'd go off hot with something, so
yeah.
That'll take a few minutes. And
nah, it's still too much time, bro.
All right. You want me to just add a minute to all the matches at this point?
No, not really. What else do we have?
We had Benoit Guerrero, Jarrett, and Steiner.
Where's Benoit Guerrero?
Right here. We had it 10 minutes.
No. You had 10 minutes. Give him 10 minutes to rest. Well, no. That's long enough, bro. Go back.
Okay.
Give Steiner and Jeff another minute.
Okay.
Give Right, let's go on. Let's see what we got. Let's just go all on. Right. Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Let's go back and get a live interview from Sting.
All right. So backstage.
Let Scott Hudson be the live interviewer in the back.
Yeah, okay. All right. So we're having a one-on-one interview, I'm assuming. Is he talking about Goldberg here?
What just took place.
Okay. So you wanted Scott Hudson. Not Scott Hall. Interviewing Sting about what just transpired with Goldberg.
Yeah.
How long?
2 minutes.
All right. And it is done. Yeah, 16 left.
That's okay. Hold on. All right, let's do this, and then we'll go back and end. It's the last match.
Yep.
It's going to be Hogan and Brett.
All right. Just straight one-on-one?
Yep.
All right, how's this go down?
Hogan's going to tap to the sharpshooter.
Oh, boy. Let's see how that goes.
Yeah, Hogan's got creative control, right?
Oh, wait. And I'm just going to put this at, say, 6 minutes for now. You could tell me. I just want to see if he blocks it. He didn't block it. He doesn't care.
I was going to say he's probably afraid of Brett. I would make this just say 10 for now with entrances.
With entrances, okay. And did you want to add any notes about the match itself?
No, after the match.
Competitive or?
Yeah, it's competitive.
Okay. And what happens after?
Brett collapses because he suffered a concussion in December and he's still wrestling.
Let's see. Do we have anything? That is going to definitely stretch my creativity there.
We got to stretch it. This is important.
All right.
Something about injury or something?
Oh, yeah. I can do it because that's going to be based on overness because it's basically he's going to be concerned. Or the fans are going to be concerned for his well-being type thing.
They're going to be concerned. We're going to send the medics out there.
It's going to be a whole big deal, so that's going to be a major.
Yeah, it's a five-minute scene.
All right. So let me... collapses in injury. So what I just did there, just as a sort of teaching about the game, when you're going through and you're seeing how good you did, it's going to tell you what happened. And all I did here is change it from celebrates their victory to after the match, the participant collapses
just
in injury.
Just change it, though. Say after the match, participant collapses due to previous injury.
Sure. All right.
And then I would go as far as stretching them out.
Injury. Scene, and you could also change what the auto name is, and I'll go over that in a video and in a little on the channel. We won't go over it now. So we have Brett sort of, he gets the stretcher job at the end of the show, you're saying?
Yep.
Do you want to do 6 minutes? Because that'll put you at, that'll give you time.
Yep.
Okay. So we have the post-match injury scene, and that is the show. Did you want to add anything after that?
Nope.
Do you want to do any dark
matches?
I would say,
I would have the announcers, can you put this in there, that the announcers lay out, like, the last 2 minutes of the show? Can you put that in there or no?
I can. It may affect your show ratings. You may just want to go just to, based on Bret Hart's overness rather than your announcer's microphone skill, just in terms of the game itself.
Okay.
So with things like this, with like Bret Hart being stretchered out, it's sort of assumed that the announcers are talking over it and they're sort of giving like that sort of thing. So you want to let like a big segment like that sort of speak for itself at the end of a show rather than put a microphone based.
Now, before you run the show, just so I know, you're going to go back and create the storylines?
Yes. And I'm also going to do something for Vince's benefit. This is the analysis button. When playing the game, this button is your best friend.
Okay.
These are all the main eventers we did not book. These people, if not booked, are going to get very angry very quickly. In fact, I would say they will get angrier than Flair for losing his match, even though they didn't lose. So we have an hour of dark time, an hour of non-TV time, that we could use these people in, that it would probably best to use these people in, to make sure they don't get angry, so that they're at least out there wrestling. Okay. Now, that's a game thing that has nothing to do with, you know, how real booking goes, because I think if you were to just throw someone into a dark match just to get them on the show, they would kind of know that you're doing that, and it wouldn't affect how they feel one way or the other. But with these, you got DDP, Bagwell, Hennig, Dustin Rhodes, Booker T, and Sid Vicious. Did you want to put any of them on the pre-show, or do you want to just let them not be on the show?
Can you go down? Can you stroll down?
Absolutely.
Because there was more, I think. I just want to see who's really upset.
Yeah. There's a lot of people not on the show right now, but
who's
these
75?
Are... 75? I'm sorry?
Evan Courageous. He'd get fired if he was that upset. Keep going.
No, these aren't people who would be upset. These are just the people who are unused.
What's the momentum mean?
I'm sorry?
What's momentum mean?
Essentially, that is a numerical value to show how much the fans buy into them. So a lower one means, like, I don't know, they've been losing for a year and no one would believe it if they started winning. And a higher one means they're red hot. So you have right now, like, for some reason, Terry Funk, people would believe it if he started winning. And then on the other side of the coin, you have Mean Mike and Tough Tom, who have no momentum whatsoever.
Yeah, I just leave it alone.
All right. So you want to go to the show?
Yep.
All right, let's see how this did. And it's going to give you your warning. Once you started, you cannot go back and alter. Oh, wait.
Wait.
Let's click
wait,
no.
Wait. Oh.
Storylines.
Oh, you got to do that, right?
Yep. So from what I saw, you do have the entire overarching Russo storyline.
Yep.
I also think we could really...
How many storylines can you put?
How many?
Yeah.
You can only have a person in one storyline at a time, but...
Well, then your storylines would be the Russo one you had, so your next storyline then would be... I don't think Hall and Nash is a storyline, but I'd say Benoit and Eddie is a storyline.
Okay. So I'm just going to name them real basic here. Chris Benoit versus Eddie. And I'll add that one. One thing I will do for your storyline is I'm going to add in Ed Ferrara. Because he was in a lot of segments that advanced this storyline. So I'm going to add him. He plays a major role, and he is aligned with Vince Russo. Now, do you
now,
want
Sting and Goldberg, would they be more in Vince's deal or in...
Nah, they'd be in their own deal.
Like their own deal, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it seemed like they started... Like, it started with Vince kind of pushing it.
Right.
But they had their own deal by... At least in my opinion. And I guess that's sort of what good writing is. All the storylines are going to merge together.
Right.
But the idea is, like... So it was Goldberg and Sting. Yep.
But I don't know how that's going to work out, though, when you can't have them work. I mean, it said Goldberg was injured for 5 months.
We could have people come in and defend Goldberg if Goldberg, if he's the heel, he could, you know, hire people and to beat Sting.
But how constant do these storylines really need to be? I mean, how often can you change them?
You can change them whenever you want.
Okay.
So it's on the fly type stuff. The main advantage of a storyline is this right here, which is the success. As a storyline progresses and you have more success or failure, you know, that's going to go up or down. So if you right. have like a positive success and you end the storyline, it's going to improve your momentum. So basically the idea is if Goldberg keeps getting one over on Sting, and then the storyline ends with Goldberg beating Sting.
Yeah.
Goldberg's going to have sky-high momentum, and Sting's going to have shitty momentum. So
now, what about the Flairs?
Would the Flairs be in the Russo storyline? Because it seemed like that all revolved around
Vince.
I
think it would be a David, Rick, Vince storyline.
Okay, so I'm going to add that to this one.
Yeah.
Now, do you want David aligned with you, or do you want him on his own?
On his own.
Okay. All right. So this storyline currently has Flair, Ferreira.
You probably want Jarrett and Steiner.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That happened. So that's their own deal, Jarrett and Steiner, or do you want them in yours?
No, that's their own deal.
All right.
I think it's EI again.
Oy. That's what the second set of eyes is for.
All right.
And just thinking over quickly, do you want the...
Brett's collapse is a storyline.
Is there anyone that you would like involved in that right now? Like,
Hogan,
do you want to have the Hogan?
I mean, Hogan was.
Not really, though.
But what we can do, and what I think would be best right now, so that you're not tipping your hand of what's going to happen in this Hart storyline, is we have it be Hart and Hogan. And then when someone else is able to jump into the storyline, you take Hogan out and you just put that new person in.
And yeah, that makes sense.
It's all just right. Something that you could do.
So go for that for now then.
Okay. Bret Hart injury storyline. All right, so we got 5. We only need 3 with a 59 heat, so... We should be okay to move forward. Was there anything else you wanted to add that I'm overlooking?
I think that's about it, from what I gather.
Yeah, I think so.
I mean, Vince's storyline covers a lot that's still not answered yet. I mean, as far as, I mean, titles and different things like that, that we don't really know where he's going to go with it. So... I think that'll be good enough to get us going with the first show and just see how we do.
All right. So do you want to run the show on this on the first show, or do you want that to be its own show, Chris? Because I just want you to... Because we could either cut it here or and then see the results on the
next
one.
Oh, no, I think we need to go ahead and see the... Well, I don't know. Right. Do we need to see the results on the deal? I guess that could be our cliffhanger every week.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
so yeah, I guess what we'll do then is, well, I'm just curious though, because when we kind of run through it now, this will be released for free, and then we'll be kicking it off afterward. So it'll go over to VIP. But I'm cool. What do you want to do, Vince? Do you want to leave the cliffhanger here and then move on, or do you want to go ahead and run the show?
What do you mean, Chris?
Well, if he presses run show, then what's the next like, what does it do after that? It just kind of shows you a recap, and then it shows what happens. Like, it gives you a grade?
Nah, I'd rather them digest it first and then come back and get the score.
Okay.
Okay.
So that's what we're going to do, guys, and here's how to work out is if you're not a VIP member, we run specials all the time. It's $5.95 a month. However, you get all kinds of stuff as a VIP member. 3 to 4 video shoot interviews between Vince Russo and a ton of wrestlers. We've had Matt Morgan. We've had AJ Styles. We've had Kurt Angle. Nearly 20 video shoot interviews that you'll get immediate access to all of. We have a private forums in there. Exclusive blogs from Vince Russo and myself occasionally, and more coming. And a lot of exclusive podcasts. Vince Russo runs down Raw every week. There's a lot. And then, of course, we're going to be adding a weekly show for this as well. Every Saturday, this will be going out. Vince Russo books Raw, actually, in a blog every Monday before Raw. So there's a lot to sign up for the VIP section. We're adding a ton as we go forward. In fact, Glenn Gilberti and Mike Sanders are going to be on there as well very, very soon with their own exclusive podcast. And as I mentioned, the private forums, which is going to be great for this stuff, the TEW, because we're going to have forums in there where you can tell us if you're playing the game and how you're booking it. And then also support between myself and Nick. We'll have Nick in there answering some questions. And you can, of course, react to Vince Russo playing TEW in the forums. So, guys, go to pyroballyhoo.com/VIP, the next show, where you can find out how Vince's very first show gets rated. Will be released next Saturday. So on the 10th, we'll be releasing the second edition, guys. Check out a score. Otherwise, if you don't sign up for the VIP, make sure you check out the free episode every single month, the first Saturday of every single month. So, guys, for that, we really appreciate you checking us out. And make sure you check out RussoPlaysTEW.com. For all the information on how you can purchase the game, obviously a link off to watch our episodes, at least the free ones on our YouTube page. Go subscribe. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube, youtube.com/pyroandballyhoo. And if you just want some more TEW stuff, Nick, who's going to be joining us each week on this on these broadcasts as well, he runs his own channel specific to TEW on YouTube. Lots of tutorials, a lot of stuff on there. And Nick, what are you doing on there right now? You're actually booking WWE, right?
I have, I think, 4 games going right now. WWE, TNA, a one where I let my viewers book for me. And that one's actually pretty fun. I really enjoy that. That's what's going up this week.
Cool.
And I also have one of the fantasy universes. So there's a lot of content on there.
And that's youtube.com/letsplayTEW. You can just go to YouTube as well and search for it. It's the first stuff that comes up. So Nick, we really appreciate you helping us out with this. And guys, obviously this first show went long. It's kind of the introductory show. Vince and I are beginners at this. Nick's the expert, so he's helping us out, and we really want to give you guys a sense of the game, and we want to ask questions that newbies will be asking as well, experts and stuff. Hopefully, those of you that have been playing these games, hopefully you'll sign up for the VIP and get involved there and let us know what you think. And then, like I said, next Saturday in the VIP section, we'll be releasing the second edition where we find out what the score was. So make sure you check out pyroandballyhoo.com. For Vince Russo and Nick Runreyes, I am Chris Cash. We'll see you next time right here on Russo Plays TEW.